students, today we will start our new part of chemistry, that is the organic chemistry. Beta, organic chemistry, organic means hydrocarbon. Organic chemistry is the branch of chemistry deals with the study of hydrocarbons and their derivatives. What do you mean by the term derivatives? Beta, hydrocarbon made up of carbon and hydrogen. The compound made up of carbon and hydrogen only. These are the hydrocarbons. Simplest hydrocarbon, as we all know, it is methane. What do you mean by the term derivatives? Derivative means hydrogen atom of hydrocarbon is replaced. Hydrogen is replaced by any of the method, and in place of hydrogen, we will add any other group. One hydrogen is replaced and add another group. This another group may be halogen, may be OH, may be amine, may be nitro. And according to these, second hydrogen, third hydrogen, that will be removed by another heteroatom. Heteroatom means that do not carbon or hydrogen. Heteroatom means either halogen, oxygen, sulfur, nitrogen, etc. And these heteroatom are used, suppose O used as OH or aldehyde ketone, that on the functional group. Sulfur present in the form of thioethers or thiols. N maybe exist in the form of nitro, maybe in the form of amine, maybe in the form of amide, maybe azide, maybe cyano, maybe isocyano, like this. And whole branch of chemistry that consists of hydrocarbons as well as their derivatives are included under the heading organic chemistry. In our syllabus, organic chemistry consists of four subunits. First one is the haloalkane, haloarene. Second one, alcohol, phenols, and ether. Third one, aldehyde ketone. And carboxylic acid. And fourth part, that is in our syllabus, is nitrogen containing compounds that are amines, nitro compounds, and diazonium salt. Only these four topics are included in plus two syllabus under the heading organic chemistry. Let us start. First of all, basic terminology about the organic chemistry. Beta, if you know all the parts included in first year, that is the plus one, that is basic concepts of chemistry as well as hydrocarbon, then it is well and good. If you don't remember all the concept, then it's okay, because the concept from hydrocarbon or basic concepts of chemistry, if used in plus two, I will explain in front of you, then it's okay. First of all, beta, what is the basic terminology? First of all, very, very first, ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री कंसिस्ट ऑफ हाइड्रोकार्बन्स एंड देयर डेरिवेटिव्स. वी आर रिलेटेड ओनली टू द हाइड्रोकार्बन्स, ओनली टू द हाइड्रोकार्बन्स. बेटा दीज हाइड्रोकार्बन्स आर क्लासिफाइड इन टू टू कैटेगरीज. सैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन, अनसैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन. सैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन्स आर दोज हाइड्रोकार्बन विच कंटेन कार्बन कार्बन सिंगल बॉन्ड ओनली. इफ द कंपाउंड कंटेन कार्बन कार्बन सिंगल बॉन्ड इट इज नोन एज एल्केन. इफ एनी ऑफ द बॉन्ड बिटवीन टू कार्बन इज डबल बॉन्ड, दैट मीन्स कार्बन कार्बन डबल बॉन्ड इज प्रेजेंट इन द गिवन हाइड्रोकार्बन, देन इट इज नोन एज एल्कीन. इफ कार्बन कार्बन ट्रिपल बॉन्ड इज प्रेजेंट इट इज नोन एज एल्काइन. मोर देन ट्रिपल बॉन्ड इज नॉट नोन टू अस. More than triple bonds are not known to us. So we are consider only carbon-carbon single bond, carbon-carbon double bond, carbon-carbon triple bond. Beta, this carbon-carbon double bond, that is alkene, again further classified into aliphatic and aromatic. Alkenes. Beta, aliphatic alkenes are all alkenes, open chain, closed chain, branched chain, etc. But aromatic hydrocarbons are those hydrocarbons which follow Huckel's rule. This Huckel rule you will study very well in your law class 11th. That is 4n plus 2 pi electrons rule. Under the Huckel rule, we have very stable compound known as benzene. It is triene. Formula is C6H6. Each carbon is sp2 hybridized. Planar geometry, follow conjugation, and most probably it follow Huckel's rule. Then it is aromatic. Any compound which follow Huckel rule, conjugation, sp2 hybridization state, planar geometry, these are aromatic. Otherwise all are aliphatic. Under the heading of aliphatic, all alkanes are aliphatic. Alkynes, are also aliphatic. Alkene with these nature is also aliphatic. But the compound which follow Huckel rule, each carbon is sp2 hybridized, planar geometry, and follow conjugation. If any compound follow all these conditions, 1, 2, 3, 4, all the four conditions, these type of compounds are known as aromatic hydrocarbons. Now, for aliphatic hydrocarbon, we will have some common name. Beta, I and other teacher all will say only IUPAC naming is in your syllabus. Either me or my other colleague friends all will say in our syllabus naming is IUPAC. But it is not correct. If I will give you compound, you will do the naming according to this committee, IUPAC committee. But in your exam, lot of conversions are there, distinctions between these and these, what will happen, and in number of questions, examiner use common name. For example, acetone. You and me also familiar with acetone. What is acetone? But propanone, for 1 second, you start to understand propanone, that means thin carbon and ketone group and all that. But acetone, directly write the formula of acetone. Acetone is the common name. Beta, it is common name. Propanone or 2-propanone. Propanone or 2-propanone, that is the IUPAC name. If I will give you a compound and name it, your answer is propane 2-one, 2-propanone or simple propanone, it is okay. But in exam, there is acetone. So common naming is also in our syllabus. Must remember some common naming like these. If you have 4-carbon in chain, it is represented by N-butyl. It is represented by N-butyl. What is this? What is this? Beta, it is valency is this one is empty. All valencies are filled by hydrogen. Valency of primary carbon is empty. It is isobutyl. It is isobutyl. If valency is empty for tertiary carbon, valency is empty for tertiary carbon, it is tert-butyl, tertiary-butyl. These are the common naming. IUPAC, 2-methyl, 2, that functional group, propane. But common name, this one. Beta, if you have 3 carbons in your chain, it is N-propyl. If you have carbon like this and this valency is empty, this is the empty valency, then it is known as isopropyl. 3 carbon means propyl. If you have 5 carbon and all carbons surround single carbon like this, and valency of any of these carbon, this carbon have fully filled. All the 4 valencies are completely filled. These 4 carbon are of same nature. All are primary. Any of the carbon have empty valency. Suppose these have empty valency. Then it is known as neopentyl. It is known as neopentyl. Neopentyl is the common name. Better, neopentyl is the common name. You learn these naming, common naming, necessarily, because in your exam, convert isobutyl into tertiary butyl. Convert isobutyl into N-butyl. Then, what will happen when N-butyl, propyl, N-butyl bromide react with this? If you know what is N-butyl, what is isobutyl, what is neopentyl, then you will solve these questions. Otherwise, you leave that question only due to the drawback of unknown of common naming. Only due to the drawback of unknown of common naming. Then, better let us start our topic, that is the haloalkane and haloarenes. First of all, halo alkene. Halo plus alkene. बेटा एल्केन इज द सैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन. एल्केन इज द सैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन. सैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन आर नोन एज एल्केन. दे कंटेन ऑल कार्बन कार्बन सिंगल बॉन्ड. ऑल द कंपाउंड कंप्लीट कंपाउंड इज सैचुरेटेड. दैट मीन्स ऑल बॉन्ड्स आर कार्बन कार्बन सिंगल बॉन्ड जस्ट लाइक दिस. It is saturated hydrocarbon. What is halo? Halo is formed by halogen. Beta, which group in the periodic table is known as halogen? Answer is group 17. Because they are sea salt forming. Because they are sea salt forming. These halogens are represented by X. It may be fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, but not astatine. Because it is radioactive hydrocarbon. Sorry, it is radioactive element or metal. Due to its radioactive nature, it will be ignored. Only fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine are included under halogens. Beta, how these compounds are formed? How these compounds are formed? As usual, hydrogen atom from the saturated hydrocarbon is replaced by any of the halogen. Hydrogen atom of saturated hydrocarbon is replaced by any of the halogens, either fluorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine. Then it is 1H is replaced, and in place of that H we will add halogen. It is known as halo alkene. It is known as halo alkene. Beta, these halo alkenes are classified on the basis of number of halogen, on the basis of position of halogens, just like on the basis of number of halogen. If one halogen is present, only one halogen is present in the compound, it is known as monohalides. It is known as monohalide. That means it have only one halogen, it is known as monohalide. If more than one halogens are present, if two halogens are present, it is known as dihalide. For example, this contain two halogen, it is dihalide. This also contain two halogen, beta. It is also dihalide. This contain two halogens, one and two, dihalide. It also contain two halogen, it is also dihalide. But when both the halogen atom present on same carbon, both the halogen atom present on same carbon, it is known as geminal dihalide. It is known as geminal dihalide. This geminal dihalide is generally represented by gem dihalide. If both the halogens present on adjacent carbon, present on neighboring carbon, it is known as vicinal dihalide. This vicinal dihalide is represented by VIC dihalide. It is known as vicinal dihalide. Beside these We also have some another type. If three halogens are present, trihalide, four tetrahalide, pentahalide, and so many. Beta, one more type of haloalkane, that is halide group is present on that carbon which is sp3 hybridized. It is haloalkane. But if this carbon attached to the halogen is combined by another carbon of sp2 hybridization state, of sp2 hybridization state, it is known as allylic halide. It is known as allylic halide. Beta, first of all you must learn common naming, some common naming, not all, only some. Then what is haloalkane? What is haloalkane? Haloalkane is the mixture of halogen and saturated hydrocarbon. From saturated hydrocarbon, one H is replaced by any method, and in place of H we will add halogen. These halogens are fluorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine, but not acetylene. Why not acetylene? Because it is radioactive in nature. So its property are not common with other elements. Now, but how you classify the haloalkane? Haloalkanes are classified on the basis of number of halogen. These number of halogens are, if one halogen present, monohalide, two halogen dihalide, three halogen trihalide, four tetrahalide, five halogen pentahalide, and so many. That is known as polyhalides. Then on the position of halogens, if one halogen is present, it is okay. Present on one carbon, it is one halo. Second carbon, two halo. Third carbon, four. Third halo. Fourth carbon, four halo, and so many. But if two halogens are present on the same carbon, that is known as geminal dihalide. Present on adjacent carbon, it is known as vicinal dihalide. But if halogen present on sp3 carbon next to the sp2, this halogen present with sp3 hydrocarbon which is next to the sp2 hybridization state, it is known as allylic halide. Beta, it is known as allylic halide. Then we are coming on haloarenes. Beta, these haloarenes, again it is made by halos plus arene. Arene means aromatic compound. Aromatic compound, and we know aromatic compound is benzene. What is the formula of benzene? It is C6H6. Again, halo is coming from the word halogen, and these halogens may be fluorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine. It is represented by generally X. Generally it is represented by X. Any of the hydrogen replaced from aromatic compound or arene. Arene means benzene. And add any of the halogen, we get haloarene or aryl halide. Beta, haloarene, IUPAC name. Aryl halide, is the common name. Common name is represented in bracket, and IUPAC name not represented in bracket. It is the main name. As usual, what is the classification of haloarene? Beta, if benzene consists of one halogen, any of the halogen but only one, it is monohaloarene. If two halogens are present, It is dihalogen. If 3, 4, 5, 6 halogens are present, that is known as polyhalide arene or polyhaloarene. Beta, on the same carbon, 2 halogens are present, that is known as geminal dihalide. That is not possible on benzene because each carbon of benzene has only one hydrogen. So, only one substituent is present on the each position of benzene. According to the position of two halogen group, beta, according to the position of two halogen group, they will be named as ortho dihalide. Clear? Are you busy naming? That is 1, 2 dihalo, arene or dihalo benzene. The same position 1, 3 is known as meta. Meta position is represented by 1, 3 dihaloarene and 1, 4. Dihaloarene, are you basically naming? This position is known as para. Para dihaloarenes are known as common naming. You must read haloarene, haloalkane up to the classification and common naming from your book after listen this video. Thank you.